Hello everybody and welcome to this next video with myself, Tony Mallett, and my good friend here, always looking great, Mike Hendricks.
Hey then guys, thank you for joining us again. How have you been?
Great, thank you Mike. And today's topic, I think we agreed, was going to be calm, confident manners.
Yeah.
Not manners when you're having a meal. Or
the band.
This is about moving forward towards your goal in a calm, confident manner. What does that actually mean and what are the benefits of it? In a nutshell, really.
Yeah, well, for many people, achieving, moving towards success, often they get discouraged when things are not moving in the direction that they'd like to see. For example, you want to lose a specific amount of weight, and we spoke about before how you have to learn to love the process. So people often get frustrated because they expect to be down to 10 pounds of weight loss within 3 weeks, which is obviously quite unrealistic, and they might get a bit angst. But understanding and staying calm and following a system or a process that you know is going to move you towards that is, strangely enough and paradoxically, going to get you there a lot quicker, as opposed to being, why is this not working, sort of thing. So it's important to remember that.
I love Mike's mannerism, calm, calm. Mike's a very calm person, but I've learned a lot by that rubbing off on me, because another aspect of being calm and confident is it's highly appealing, it's highly attractive for those leaders out there who want followers. If you've got a calm, confident manner, it's really, really great. Mm. Really quickly, do you mind if I tell you a quick story,
Mike? Yeah.
So, funny enough, there was a shark on the news recently.
Yeah, I saw that. Called huge shark.
Deep Blue, and this shark's 20 feet long, and there was a diver swimming next to the shark in a very calm, confident manner, and we were laughing and saying, how come the shark didn't eat the diver? Well, Mike's just told me that the shark had been eating lots and lots of food off a big carcass in the water, so it's full up, didn't want to eat anymore, so the diver was able to go along with the shark. So here's Sharky. Sharky is not calm and confident. Sharky just wants to get it all done now and bash through life and get out of my way. Oh, why has it not come yet? Not calm and not confident, and then just worries every night that things aren't going right. But he's watching at the same... It's a bit like the tortoise and the hare, this. He's watching at the same time this character here. We'll call him Freddy. Here's Freddy here. Freddy's got strings. And the shark's always taking the mickey out of Freddy and saying, Freddy, you've got strings, you know, you're not free like me. I mean, I can bash things out of the way and I'm going to get there, I'm going to make it. And very calmly, Freddy turns around and says, yeah, I have got strings, but they make me move in a sort of a slow, calm, confident manner towards my dream. But the shark doesn't like that. Anyway, the shark goes sailing forward in a very bad attitude and ultimately wears himself out, because another aspect of being calm and collective and confident is, if you're not like that, you're probably going to affect your health.
Yes,
would you agree, Mike?
Absolutely.
So Fred, meanwhile, he just takes these small, calm, daily, confident steps forward, and the shark is trying to get ahead, but the shark ultimately wears himself out, and he's just burnt out. And Fred, a bit like the hare and the rabbit, looks around and says, okay, I'm just going to calm. I can't make his... let's see if we can make his legs work. Calmly make my way forward. Bye. See, Mike's laughing now. But you know what? There's a great lesson if you can imagine yourself walking around with strings attached, you would imagine that you'd be walking in a very different way. Your manners would be very different because you're controlled. And I think you have to put that mental discipline on yourself. How am I behaving? How am I moving? How am I talking throughout my day? Is it calm and confident? And you can work on that.
Yeah, it's something that we can all develop, because anytime you are stepping out to achieve something, naturally, there's going to be fear, there's going to be a level of anxiety, there's going to be a level of doubt that's going to perhaps stop you. But if you're following a process or a system, and it's like I always say to my clients, you know, bringing it back to health and fitness, which is obviously my sphere of expertise, is that people sometimes ask me, well, what diet should I follow? Now, often people will say, this is the best diet, and this is the best diet you should follow, this diet, this diet, this diet. I often said the fact that you are following a system is going to help you move forward, because you're following a system that's going to allow you to move in a calm and confident manner towards a specific goal. What's the best way to lose weight? You can follow the, you know, paleo diet, you can follow a Weight Watchers diet, you can follow the all in vogue at the moment, which is the vegan diet or vegetarian diet or a meat only diet. There are different arguments as to what's the best diet to follow, but the fact that you're following a system, a process, is leading you in a calm and a confident way that has step one, step two, step three, step four, that's going to ultimately lead you to the goal. And that's the idea of following a system, being calm and confident. You're developing, you're learning these steps, steps to follow along the way that's ultimately going to lead you towards a goal.
Absolutely. And when you do meet calm, confident people, I'm sure we all have met those people, aren't they highly attractive? They're people that you want to, and you want to almost tie them down and say, or pin them down and say, what's your secret? How you know, you might be in debt, you might have a huge challenge or risk on your hand, but they just stand tall, back straight, heads held high, and it's calm and confident. And I think it echoes that they also have a knowledge about their potential, that where they can go as well.
Yeah, so the takeaway for today, for you watching this video, is you can develop calm, you can develop confidence. So even if you find yourself in a situation currently where you want to change, you want to move forward, you want to seek something that's not currently in your existence or your life at the moment, but you know that you're going to have to step out, know that you can develop that confidence, you can develop that calmness in order to reach your particular goals. And there are going to be ups and downs. That's something that you have to be aware of. There's going to be days which are great, and there's going to be days where not so great, but as long as you follow a process and you move confidently in the direction of your goal, you will ultimately get there.
Absolutely, yeah.
Now, if you want to find out more about how you can develop that calmness and develop confidence to move towards your goals, keep tuning back here, because over the next few videos, we're going to be talking to you about our Think to Thrive workshop, which you can get involved with. Now, we'd love to hear your comments. We'd love to hear what you think about this particular video and all the other videos that we've been posting up recently. If you found it of value, you found it of benefit, we'd love for you to give us a thumbs up, share it with your circle of influence, and even leave us a comment down below. So, until next time, I'm Fred and the Worn-Out Shark.
So there's one thing we're going to remember today is you've got strings. You know, you've got strings to be calm. So, yeah, from Fred, from Mike.
Until next time, guys, to your success.
To your success.